Am I walking funny?
A little bit. So on Friday, after I finished the show, I decided to go for a late night snack. So I went to this restaurant in the valley, the San Fernando Valley. You can see it over there. I won't say the name. I won't say the name of it because we may be going to court. So, but what happened was I had this stir-fried chicken dish, right? And it was delicious. I thought, this is delicious. Is this chicken a little undercooked? I thought, no, no. It's fine. Fine. A little pink. It's a little pink. That's all right. A few hours later, things got a little spectacular. Now, I don't want to go into too much. You know, obviously, you understand the details of this kind of thing. Stuff was going on. All available routes were being used. And, I'm married to a woman, and I'd quite like to stay married to her, but she was outside that room, and she was hearing things. Things she'll never be able to unhear. But you know what was the worst of it? The worst of it was this. As it's going on, as this utter madness is occurring in my body, this twister is going through me. And it went through pretty fast. It was over by the morning. But people coming out of storm drains and stuff. But as it's happening, I thought, I've been in LA too long. Because as it was occurring, I thought, ooh, I'm losing weight.
Of Bourbon Street. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I'd like to thank you. I'd like to thank the Academy. I'd like to thank. Oh, hang on. I'd like to thank you. I'd like to thank the Academy. Oh, yeah. Check it out. That's right. I'm a great big lady. Holy crackers. Did you see that? Like, wow, Jeff Peterson, get off the stage! It's a great day for America, everyone. I love the dude that came on after her and did it. Like, I wish he was my friend. It's a great day for Hollywood, of course. 40 million people watched the Oscars last night. To give you an idea how many that is, you take the number of people that have seen the movie The Artist and add 40 million. I actually watched that. I wasn't that bad. I thought Billy did great. He was out there doing his thing. He was great. And then this happened. I was outraged. I have that same dress. Now, in heterosexual news, the Super Bowl of NASCAR... The Daytona 500 was supposed to be yesterday, but it was rained out. It's the first time it ever happened. Who the hell are you? Don't come here with your positive feedback. I don't know what the hell to do with this. Anyway, over the weekend, Mitt Romney went to Daytona. I think he was collecting motor oil for his hair, but he wanted to give people that, you know, he's like a regular dude, not a rich fat cat who's made of money. And this is true. He said to a reporter, "I don't follow NASCAR closely, but I have a great friends who are NASCAR team owners." Don't you even want to try and win this thing? Didn't help that he shouted out of a golden helicopter as well. The other presidential candidate, Rick Santorum, he doesn't even pretend to like NASCAR. He's against any activity where dudes can rear-end each other. But the day... but the Daytona... Where do you learn? Who said, "Yeah, do this"? Like... What, do that? Yeah, do that. Everyone will be talking about it. You're right. Anyway, the Daytona 500, it finally happened today. Yeah, I watched it because we were live, and it was awesome. Yeah, congratulations, the winner. Apparently, apparently NASCAR officials spent all day trying to dry the track. I think they used a giant ShamWow. That's the best way to get rid of Dick Trickle. There, I said it. Now, I said it. You know, when you're talking about NASCAR, you got to mention Dick Trickle. Just like if I'm talking about, you know, outer space, I have to talk about Uranus. It's what I do. It's in my blood. It's like, it's my version of this. I'm going to do this in Starbucks. I was like, what are you doing? Anyway, I'm a big fan of NASCAR. I know what you're thinking, Craig. You're an effete European talk show whore. I'm surprised you like NASCAR. Well, I like a lot of things that might surprise you, mister. I like NASCAR. I like warm bubble baths. I like crystal meth. I like doing this. NASCAR's very, very exciting, though. You know, you watch it on the TV. Sometimes it's so thrilling, I grab the nearest item in the house and I just clutch onto it for dear life. I've killed 4 of my ferrets that way. Joke. Back in the 1990s, I'd just gotten sober and I went to Charlotte, North Carolina to the NASCAR driving school because I was doing this little travel movie for British Airways. And they sent me because they had a new flight to Charlotte from London. And they called me up and they said, "I say, Albie, and the Yanks have these smashing motor cars. Go and make a little film about it, would you? What? That's how people in British Airways spoke in the 90s, you know? How Downton Abbey was... Oh, never mind. Anyway, look. The NASCAR track was great there on Charlotte. It was our bank track, but the fumes from all the cars were very overpowering and made me very lightheaded and disoriented, which was awesome because I was just out of rehab. Riding around the track was scary. The G-forces are so intense, I actually fainted. The last time that happened is when I heard there was a sale on at Hot Topic, but before that... The best part about going that fast, though, is you go that fast and you get there. Mm-hmm, oh, yeah. Give me a picture of what I looked like when I got out of the car. Yeah, like that, that's a... Don't judge. The one thing I remember most about being at the NASCAR races was the noise that is deafening. That's why they have the Daytona 500 is in Florida, because the old people who live there, they can't hear anything. They're just like... Hey, I like watching the cars going around. Ah, yes. The aging process. I loved hearing the roar as the cars went by. You know, that's one reason that NASCAR should never be replaced by electric cars. Because you don't want to be a NASCAR racing here. We have something very similar to NASCAR here in LA. It's on the TV every night. Millions tune in to watch it. It's called the High Speed Police Chase. Same winner every time, though. You should come out if you ever get caught in a police. Say you're on a crystal meth run and the cops come after you and you get caught in a chase. What you should do is get out of the car and go, Can I help you? Hey. Did you watch the Oscars last night, Jeff?
Yeah.
You like them?
Oh, it was great. I had a little Oscar party. It was great.
Yeah. Billy, I thought Billy was good.
He like was
Billy?
Incredible.
Yeah, he's great. Yeah.
How about that leg, man?
Yeah, it was a bit of a fright. When that happened, I was like, what the hell?
I particularly like when you do it.
Thanks, I've been working on it all day.
No, I want you to do it again.
You've taken something beautiful and you've made it dirty. Thanks, pal.
You got it, pal.
Do the thing.
Why not? All right. You're watching The Late Late Show. One of us is a depraved, effete automaton, and the other is a robot.
Yeah, you know, I was talking about the Oscars earlier when I did that thing with my leg.
Oh, is that what we're calling it?
Well, you know, because that movie that won, The Artist, the silent movie, it won big at the Oscars last night. Five Oscars! Oscars, and Oscars. Five of them! Best Picture! It made it Best Picture, and I'm like, what? What? What about the silent movie that I made? Craig, you made a silent movie? Yes, I did! When did you make it? Well, I won an Oscar, so I made it this afternoon. Take a look at this. Kissed Bridger. We'll be right back.
have to do it on the other side now or I'll be walking in circles on. My first guest tonight is a comedy legend. He's got a new stage show, What About Dick? Wait. At the Orpheum Theatre, April the 26th to the 29th. These tickets are on sale now. Please welcome the great Eric Idle, everybody.
You don't want him getting too above himself.
Hello, Eric.
How are you?
I'm very well. How are you?
I'm pretty good, actually.
Yeah, you look well. You look nice. You look wealthy.
Well, I am.
Yeah. I think it's terrific. I like seeing people I like having lots of money. Do you have a boat?
A boat?
Yeah, a boat.
No, I have a punt. I got nothing.
No. What about this? This is a DVD.
Oh, yeah, they're just re-releasing the Holy Grail again. You know, forget right, about that.
So, what about Dick, then?
I've got time.
Yeah. That's not encouraged here. Is it a musical?
It is. It's a play with songs, actually. But it is. There's a slight difference. I mean, it's a play I've been writing for many, many years.
Right.
And it stars Russell Brand.
I know Russell.
Yes. He plays an Oxford undergraduate who's not sure whether he's studying psychology or gynecology. And it's...
That's Russell.
Yes, that's very much Russell. It's the rubber gloves that confuse him.
Yeah.
It has Eddie Izzard.
I know Eddie.
You know Eddie Izzard.
What is Eddie doing?
Eddie is playing a character called Deepak Rushdie Obi Ben Kingsley. And he's from Shagistan is where he's from. And yeah. And Billy Connell is in it too.
Oh really?
Yeah. I'm familiar with that gentleman.
Yeah. He plays an inspector.
Does he play Scottish inspector?
And he sings a song called The Lonely Trout.
Right. Well, hold on a second. He's a Scottish inspector now. Does that mean he expects people for how Scottish they are?
Yes, very much
so. I just have to see how Scottish you are. How cautious with money are you?
What is worn under the kilts?
Nothing. It's all in perfect working order.
Thank you very much. Ching.
Do you know the other one?
No.
What does a Scotsman wear under his kilt? On a good day, lipstick. You never heard that one?
Yeah. We also have Tracy Ullman.
Oh, yes.
Yes, and she plays a Cockney lady called Enid.
Right.
Who is an ass reader.
Talk me through that.
She's an astrologer.
Right.
And she predicts the future by reading the wrinkles on your tush.
I wish I had seen her last Friday night, I tell you.
And I've got Jane Leaves.
She plays
Emma Thompson. And Sophie Winkleman plays Helena Bonham Carter.
All right.
And Jim Piddock plays the working classes. All of them.
I've worked with Jim Piddock before.
He's very funny.
He's very funny. Yes, he's English, you know. Is that all right?
All the cast are English.
Yeah. Well, no, Billy's not.
Billy's Scottish.
Yeah, Billy's
Scottish.
Yes, yes. Yeah. At least he was the last time I inspected him. Are you in it then? Are you?
Yes, I'm in it. I play the piano. Which is the lead character who tells the story. It's the first play ever narrated by a piece of furniture.
I'm sure we'll get emails telling us that that's not true.
Because, yes, somebody once played the bagpipes as Macbeth.
Right.
Don't say...
Why did you have to say it? Why?
It's only a theatre. We're not in a theatre.
No, we're not technically in a television studio, are we? You know, I like to try and observe the niceties, though. Yeah. How have you been? I haven't seen you for ages. Have you been back over in Blighty or something?
No, I've been here.
You've been working?
I've been writing, yeah. I write away. I don't come out much.
Well, when you do come out...
I bring out my dick.
Don't look... See, now, that's your motive.
What he means
by that, what he means by that is his play. Will that
I
help?
Play yeah. What about Dick?
Yeah, right,
yeah,
right.
Yes.
And now it's obviously a play on words.
or not. Actually, it's more foreplay on words.
Yeah, it's always nice when you're here, Eric. I always feel that I'm not the smuttiest one in the room again.
Although we know you are.
Listen, we have to do a commercial break. Do you fancy having a go at, you know, throwing to the commercial break?
Yes, I'll be happy to do that.
Well, I know that, you know, a lot of the Python stuff is in the BBC. I don't know if you've ever tried it before.
Oh, what would you like me to do?
Well, you know, just throw
I
it.
I thought I was going to play the harmonica.
No, you'd have to do that later if you want to try for the
later.
Moment. Yeah, so we have a commercial break in between
what do I say?
To try and so, get a better studio.
So something like, we'll be right back after this message.
Sounds good to me. Well, maybe not. Welcome back, everybody. I'm talking to Eric Idle, but not about anything you want to hear. Well, Eric, we're out of time.
Thank God for that.
Yeah. So, as we're out of time, may I inquire which you would prefer on the way out? Would you like an awkward pause?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like a mouth organ?
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to touch the horse as it runs by you? Is this a new one I've just invented right there?
I'd quite like a go with a mouth organ.
Oh, right, okay.
If that's okay.
Sure.
Yeah?
Yeah.
May I?
Yeah, let me work up to it. I
okay,
there.
Okay.
You know, I don't want to go rushing in and, you know, just...
Or I'll touch the horse's ass, I don't know.
Well, let's see. You know, if you can play the mouth organ, you can win the golden mouth organ.
Oh, you can?
I think you know about this. When Billy Connolly was here,
Billy
won the golden mouth organ because he could play.
Yeah.
Can you play?
A little.
Well, let's just see if you've got enough of what it takes to win the... No, you have to take it out of the box.
Oh, sorry.
Are you ready?
Okay.
Well...
A bale of cotton.
Last night at the Oscars when Cameron Diaz and Jennifer Lopez. Yeah, I got it. When they both did that thing at the end, when they turned around and I'm thinking, well, Jennifer Lopez, you know what I mean? And then I'm thinking, if I'm Cameron Diaz, do I want to be part of that competition? But like, you know, when Jennifer says, you know what we should do? And Cameron Diaz went, yeah, all right. You think, no, we should not do that. My next guest is a very beautiful actress. She stars in Game Change, which premieres March the 10th on HBO, which is not even television. Take a look at this. Hey. Don't overdo it. It sounds patronizing. Sarah Paulson, everybody. Sarah Paulson.
I
think I might have just got served there.
You sure did.
Did you serve me?
I did.
You look great, though.
Thank you.
I love your dress. It's...
Thanks. I like your tie.
So you don't like the rest of it?
Nope.
I see. You only like the tie.
Just the tie.
I like the dress.
All right.
And I like everything else, too.
Oh, you...
I do. It gives the appearance of being see-through, but in fact, disappointingly isn't.
I don't think you'd be that excited if you really saw what was under there.
First of all, I think that's very self-deprecating.
That's true.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think I'd be reasonably excited.
You'd be like...
No, I'd be like, mm-hmm. Well done. Let's see where you're... Wow, look at those shoes. Like, get them up there.
Thank you.
Very nice indeed. I like a good shoe.
I like a good sparkly thing.
I like sparkly things too.
Yeah.
I've got a Peabody Award. But I do like sparkly things. You know, I should have mentioned that to Bishop Desmond Tutu when
you
he was
should.
Here. Yeah. Do you like sparkly things?
Yes, I do. Yeah.
He probably does, actually.
He does.
Yeah, yeah. Have you ever been to South Africa?
No, I think you asked me this last time I was here.
No way!
Yes, you did.
No way! That's not possible.
No, I think you did.
No, I think I didn't. What the hell, Sarah? Why are you being mean to me? Is it because of this part and your game changer thing where you're tough and in charge?
Very serious.
Yeah.
Intelligent and...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you watch the Oscars then?
I did watch the Oscars.
Were they great?
They were great.
Positive.
Yeah, I like
that. Nice. Where did you learn that?
I don't know. It's like a...
A thing?
Yeah, a thing I do. It's true. Sometimes I'll watch a movie or a play or be talking to a human, and if I don't like what they're saying, I'm like... Thumbs down, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I do. Yeah. Like... You should have been around earlier. We did a silent movie. You would have fit right in.
I thought it was...
Where are you from?
You asked me that.
I did ask you that. Yes. See, exactly. I know exactly where you're from. It's a region.
Quiet. Quiet. I'm going to answer the question
now. All right.
Oh. Do you cream?
Yeah, right there when you did that to my hand. Your move.
I was miming a checkmate.
Oh, were you? No.
Yeah.
Now, you were going to talk about where you're from.
I don't remember where I'm from.
Really?
No. I'm from Tampa, Florida.
I do remember now. Because it's near...
Sharky areas. We talked about
sharks.
That's
right. We talked about sharks. Yeah. But I don't want to talk about sharks.
Me neither. We did that.
Oh, that's gone. You ever been to Catalina?
Yes.
There's a lot of sharks around the other side of Catalina. You got to be careful about that. Great whites.
There are not. Are there?
Oh, yeah.
Great whites?
Oh, yeah.
California? Really?
Am I
dumb? I'm being an idiot.
No. Have you ever heard of the Farallon Islands? They're off the coast of...
What now?
I think it's Farallon they're called.
Farallon
Islands. Yeah, they're off the coast of San Francisco. They're about 15 miles out. Largest collection of great white sharks in the world. And the water's very murky. That's why you don't go filming them. And that's why you don't go near it. Because they just... you don't get any warning at all.
But you didn't go swimming there with them. You went swimming in...
The Bahamas.
The Bahamas.
Yeah.
In a cape.
You ever been to the Bahamas?
No.
Do you ever go, to anyone?
I'm like, wah, Bahamas.
Well, where do you go on vacation then if it's not anywhere tropical or sharky?
On vacation? I haven't been on vacation in a while. I live a very quiet life.
But you can still go on a vacation.
No, like a quiet, like sad life where I don't leave the house. I don't leave the house a lot. I watch a lot of reality television.
Do you watch House Hunters International?
I don't watch House Hunters. I watch The Housewives. I know, but also, really, is that terrible?
Yeah, these people aren't well. You shouldn't watch
them.
No. I don't want to encourage that kind of thing.
But what about American Idol?
Them too.
I watch it and I sob. It's bizarre. It's weird.
Do you have a singing voice?
No. No. Ooh. Would you like to hear it? Hey.
You're going to Hollywood!
That was pretty. That was,
thank you.
No.
Sad.
No, no, I just think you made the right choice for your wife. No, it was good. I liked your earrings. They're
you
very.
Do?
Yeah, they're bold.
They are kind of bold,
yeah,
aren't they?
Yeah, they are. Did they hurt your ears? Have you got pierced ears?
Do you want to try one on?
Well, are they pierced ears?
No. Oh, yes, they are. But we could kind of hook it in the little bottom part of your
ear. I got a pierced ear.
Oh.
But I you can't do. We can't do that.
Why not?
No, we can't do that.
I think you look really good in a dress.
When have you seen
me
in a dress?
I saw you. You did a skit on this show where you were Sarah Palin and you wore a sort of dress outfit, a red outfit and a wig. And I thought
that wasn't on the show.
Yes, it was.
No, no, that was just something we were doing.
Nope. No.
We're out of time.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah. So.
This was great.
Yeah, it was kind of.
Kind of like, hey, yeah.
So I'm thinking, what do you fancy? Awkward pause? You want to go for the mouth organ? Although I don't know about that tonight. Or do you want to go for the big cash prize?
I'm going to go for the big cash prize.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
I thought you might.
You did, right?
Yeah. That's why I said we're done about 5 minutes before we're done. To give you time.
Yeah.
See?
Yeah,
see what I'm doing? Okay. I got it. What time is the show to stay with?
Time for the big cash prize.
Big cash prize. Here comes that. $50. $50. Hey. You don't touch it till you earn it. And also the money. The $50 in quarters in a bag with a dollar sign on it.
Okay.
Just like the burglars use. Right?
Yep.
Two ways to win. You can either answer a question or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works.
In your box?
Yes, yes.
You have a box?
You bet I do.
Oh.
Yeah. You don't know about that?
No, no. Right.
Yeah, it could be. I imagine a box in my head, but I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. So you try and guess what's in it, and if you're right, Jeff will tell us, and if you're wrong, something awful will happen. When I say happen, I mean happen. Something awful
something
will
awful
happen.
I love it when something awful happens. I do, happen.
Happen, yeah.
And then what is the other option? If I don't guess what's in your box, there's something else? Or was that the whole
thing? No, this is...
Okay, oh, don't God. Yell at me. Okay, what's in your... what's in your box?
Well, you want to play guess what's in the box?
Yeah.
All right. Jeff, I'm imagining a box. Do you feel the box, Jeff?
Mm-hmm.
Jeff feels the box.
Mm-hmm.
Jeff. Okay, there's something in the box. Do you want to take a guess?
What's in the box?
Mm-hmm.
And it's a thought or it's an actual item?
I don't know. Only Jeff knows.
What's in the box? Mm-hmm. A crow.
I can hear some scuffling. Jeff, what is in the box?
We would have accepted cream. A crow is the correct answer.
The correct answer! We went crazy. The show went so fast, and we didn't do emails, Jeff.
It's unbelievable.
I know. I can't believe we went through a whole show and didn't do emails.
It's reprehensible.
It's... What kind of talk was that? It sounds a little Downton Abbey to me.
As do you have a problem with it, sir?
Well, I'm absolutely...
What did you say?
Well, not only am I, but I'm also.
Well, I never.
On the contrary, sir, I think you did very many times. So let's do them now, quickly. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's that part on the show where Craig reads your letters and doles out unreliable and grossly irresponsible advice.
Don't play the thing. No, don't! Don't!
Oh, they were getting all ready to play it, weren't they? We don't have time. We don't have time. We have to do the emails quickly before the end of the show.
Quickly, quickly, make haste, man.
All right, this is from Janice in Fall River in Massachusetts. Dear Craig and Jeff, the dress my husband bought for my birthday is two sizes too big. Should I be insulted? No. Get eaten. This is from Jared in Cleveland, Ohio. Ooh, I wonder if it's Jared from the sandwiches. You know, Jared.
Ooh, yes, of course. I wonder if Jared... Did Jared take the train to Cleveland?
He may have taken the train to Cleveland. I don't know if it was a locomotive train, though, Jeff. It may have been some other sort of train.
Like a steam engine, perhaps.
Could have been a steam engine. That's a legitimate form of train transportation.
Quickly, quickly now, quickly.
Quickly, quickly. Jared says... My friends want to take me to a strip club for my birthday, but my wife is a feminist and says that's disgusting. You're not a real person. This is from Sean in Austin, Texas. Dear Craig, Jeff, and... Wait, it says secretariat, but we don't have time for secretariat, so we'll just do a very quick out the door and in the door. All right, just a very quick one. Don't start. Who's that at the door? That's enough, sit out. We don't have time for any more. Dear Craig, Jeff, and Secretary, I just found out my wife doesn't like Star Wars. Did I make a mistake? Yep. This is from Glenn in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, says, hey, Craig and Jeff, is it insulting to offer beads to women to remove their shirts when it's not Mardi Gras? Jeff?
Yep.
This is from Kyle in Tiverton in Rhode Island. Oh, I've been to Rhode Island. Have you ever been to Rhode Island?
That's lovely.
Oh, yeah.
Got a place there, as a matter of fact.
Have you really?
Sure, sure.
What do you do at your place at Rhode Island?
I like to swim nude and throw beads.
We better get going, then.
Well, quickly, right, quickly. Right.
Hi, Craig and Jeff. Tomorrow I have to give a 20-minute presentation on a topic I know nothing about. Do you have any pointers on faking it? Voila. This is from Molly. This is from Molly in Rome, in New York. You ever been to Rome?
Absolutely.
Have you ever been to Rome, Italy?
Oh, yes, I've got three places there.
Dear Craig and Jeff, my husband always cries way before I do during chick flicks. Is that weird? No, not if he's gay. This is from Caroline. Oh, we don't have much time. This is Caroline in Atlanta, Georgia. I don't know if you can tell, but Caroline's a nice little soft, fuzzy tit. Dear Craig and Jeff, and Secretariat, don't have time for that. People say, let's do a quick, slow Secretariat. Is that even possible?
Yeah.
Let's do Secretariat very quickly, but slowly. You ready? Ready. All right. Dear Craig and Jeff, people say your ears are burning when someone is talking about you. Do you think this is true? And finally, this is from Matt in Trenton, New Jersey. You ever been to Trenton, New Jersey?
No.
Okay. Dear Craig and Jeff, I'm going bald and have recently started wearing a toupee. Am I officially over the hill? No, but you are fodder for children's laughter.